Let's give a warm welcome to Josh Mankiewicz.
Welcome, and thank you for joining us for the 2016 Above and Beyond Awards Ceremony and Luncheon. I am very much proud to be here today. The word hero is thrown around a lot in my business, to the point where it doesn't always mean what it should, but it is really an honor to be in a room full of genuine heroes who meet that definition by anybody's standard and with the families who have supported them, and also the family of one person who gave his life to protect and to serve. Today we are here to recognize 57 heroes whose service and courage deserve our eternal gratitude, because when faced with the decision of self-preservation or self-sacrifice, they responded with bravery and with selflessness. This afternoon, the Los Angeles Police Department honors them with the department's three most prestigious awards: the Medal of Valor, the Purple Heart, and/or the Preservation of Life. Now, later in this ceremony, you're going to hear their stories that tell the narrative of this world-class police department, whose men and women exhibited tremendous bravery protecting the people of Los Angeles, and in some cases, protecting one another. Now I'm going to ask for you all to please stand for the LAPD's Honor Guard, followed by the singing of the National Anthem by Officer Rosalind Curry.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home
This is one of my favorite days of the year. A chance for this city of angels to come together to honor those guardian angels that are here with us. This weekend over Labor Day, I spent time with my family. And my father brought out a keepsake in my own family. My grandfather Salvador, who was an immigrant to this country, who grew up in Boyle Heights, who I often say LAPD changed his life. I'll tell you how. When he was a young man, I remember being with him later in his life. We were at his house, and I was a young boy, and a picture of a distinguished-looking gentleman came on the television. My grandfather says, "I know that man. He's the mayor of Los Angeles, Tom Bradley." And this was long before my father was in politics. Nobody knew the last name Garcetti. I was blown away that this humble barber, a man who had served his country in the United States Army, knew the mayor of the city of Los Angeles. And I said, "Grandpa, how do you know Tom Bradley?" And he said, "Well, when I was younger, and he was younger, he arrested me." And while it was a funny story to think that years later, I would be the successor to the successor to the successor of that man who, when he was a Los Angeles police officer, arrested my grandfather, he said that day changed my life. And it turned his life around so that he not only got his life together, he volunteered to fight in World War II, he became a citizen, he learned to be a barber, and I'm standing here today because of him. And this weekend, my dad brought out his uniform from the United States Army, where he became a sergeant in the Pacific Theater. And he's no longer with us, unfortunately. But all of us could see the medals that he won on his uniform. And for each one of the officers today who will be honored, for putting your body and life on the line, for extraordinary heroism, and for preserving lives in our city, there will be a grandchild of yours, maybe after you're gone, or a great-grandchild, who will pull out your LAPD uniform and will see that honor that you receive here today. And just as I felt this weekend, will feel a surge of pride, a connection with who you are and what this city is about. If you turn on the television these days, you'd think that all police officers are doing are bad things. And that's wrong. Because while these are the most heroic acts we are going to honor here today, we know every single day there is heroism in this department. I began my day today in Van Nuys with a group of Los Angeles police officers and Councilwoman Nuri Martinez, members of the HOPE teams that are doing outreach with homeless individuals who are living on our streets. These folks look forward to seeing these police officers. They know them by name, and the officers know these individuals by name. They're helping them get ID cards and social security cards, finding a place to shower and a place to get their lives cobbled back together. And so I stand here before you to thank each and every one of you, starting first with the families that support our men and women. Second, give them a round of applause, because you, every day, sacrifice something when they are gone. And second, to the wider community who supports our officers, our sponsors that are here, our police commissioners who volunteer their time, our reserve officers who have double duty, our public safety partners in the fire department and other agencies who join with us. And then finally, we are here on behalf of the 4 million souls of this city of angels to say thank you. Thank you for touching our lives. Thank you for saving our lives. Thank you for protecting our lives. And most of all, thank you for changing our lives. That's what a police officer is about. When she or he heads out, a good day's work is one in which you have changed the lives of many. Keep on with that mission. We are behind you. And thank God for the Los Angeles Police Department. Thank you so much.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the chair of the Los Angeles Police Foundation, Jim Wyatt.
Thank you. On behalf of the Los Angeles Police Foundation's Board of Directors, I want to welcome you to the Above and Beyond Award Ceremony. It is our privilege to be a part of such a distinguished ceremony, one that touches our hearts and makes us so proud of the men and women of the LAPD. For all of the families, friends, and supporters who joined us this afternoon to honor and celebrate this remarkable occasion, we are glad you're here. I would like to take a moment to thank Officer Sarah Faden, Executive Director Cecilia Glassman, and the dedicated staff of the Los Angeles Police Foundation for all of their diligent efforts in organizing this event. I'd appreciate it if you would stand to be recognized. And this is Sarah Faden over here. To Mayor Garcetti, thank you for your unwavering support of our city's finest. We are so glad you could join us today. To Chief Beck and the Police Commission, it is our pleasure to work with you in honoring these officers for their extraordinary acts of bravery and service. It means so much to our city to know that we are protected by such heroic individuals. We cannot thank them enough for their efforts in keeping the citizens of Los Angeles safe. Additionally, I would like to thank my fellow Los Angeles Police Foundation board members and ask them to be standing to be recognized. And to all of our sponsors who have made it possible for us to celebrate today's recipients, thank you for caring so much about these brave men and women. To the 57 officers who are being recognized today, we salute you, we are proud of you, and we are honored to share this day with you. Thank you so very much for coming.
We want to thank all of our generous sponsors for making this event possible and for showing your commitment to making our community safer and supporting the LAPD. I'd like to invite Martha Saucedo, Executive Vice President of External Affairs for AEG, to come to the stage and be thanked for their four-star sponsorship. Now I'd like to invite Jerry Birch, Southern California Area Sales Manager of Motorola Solutions Incorporated, to the stage and thank them for their four-star partnership. We would especially like to thank Harris Daily Wells for generously committing to being the presenting sponsor of this event. Would Lori Thompson, Vice President of Business Strategy and Business Development, please join us on stage here?
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Lori Thompson. I am the Vice President of Strategy and Business Development for Harris Communications System Business, which proudly provides technology to support first responders and warfighters who serve and protect our nation every day. On behalf of all 21,000 Harris employees, I would like to thank Cecilia Glassman and the entire Los Angeles Police Foundation. Harris is very proud to sponsor an event who recognizes those who have gone above and beyond, and I am honored and humbled to be among such distinguished company today. We are honoring extraordinary acts of valor and heroism today, and we are honoring people whose steadfast dedication to serving others is unparalleled. All of you in this room show up each and every day and put your lives in danger to protect others. You take your oath to serve and protect seriously. And for that, I commend you and thank you for your service. Public safety users here and around the country remind us every day how critical reliable communications are to saving lives and protecting our communities. Everyone at Harris understands that our equipment plays a vital role in our customers' lives, your lives, every day. We thank you for entrusting us with that role. With several decades of focus in mission-critical systems, our experience shows in our many innovative communication platforms and first-of-kind solutions. We remain committed to the public safety sector and promise to keep your communications lifeline our highest priority. Harris Daily Wells, today we congratulate our award recipients, and we thank you for placing your lives on the line to protect the citizens of this great and historic city. We are privileged and grateful to serve those who serve us. Thank you very much.
Being the host of this particular award show is very difficult. You know, you have extremely emotional stories to tell, and many times our hosts have trouble getting through them, and I understand that. And Josh has generously stepped up to the plate today to do this for us, and I want to recognize him, and I want to thank him for what he does every day, reporting on important stories and doing it in a way that all of us can believe in. So, Josh.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sergeant Eric Rogers, and as mentioned, I'm one of the department chaplains, and it's truly an honor for me and a privilege to be here to pay honor to those who are receiving their awards today. I've had the opportunity to connect with several of the recipients, and this is definitely a proud day for the Los Angeles Police Department. As you know, September 11th is soon approaching us in the next few days, and it's the 15th year anniversary this year of September 11th, 2001. And it's the day that we now call Patriot Day. And on September 11th, 2001, our nation was changed forever. We realized that we were not exempt anymore from the violence of those, from those who wished to bestow it upon our nation. It was a day we'll all remember in which evil was brought to our doorstep. It was a day when the enemy made its presence known to us and that they are willing to challenge our freedom. On September 11th, 2001, people from around the world caught a glimpse of what it's like to be a police officer or a first responder. Those people around the world learned the true meaning of a hero and what it really is. They saw those men and women in blue running towards the danger when everyone else was running away. They saw heroism played out when those in blue lived out a commandment given to us in the book of John, which says, "There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friend." In today's climate, it's challenging, to say the least, to be a police officer, to be an effective police officer, that is. And it's a demanding job. To say it's a demanding job is an understatement. However, police work is not a seasonal occupation. And what I mean by that is, we don't change our work ethic based on the current political climate. As Los Angeles police officers, we remain professional at all times in the midst of fear, rebellion, public perception, etc. Our job doesn't deviate on any given factor. We are here to protect and serve, and we will continue doing that to the end of time. Every day, police officers from around the world risk their lives in order to keep order. And on September 11th alone, we lost 60 of our brothers and sisters. It's a job unlike any other, where we have sworn to protect and to serve members of a community, even if it costs us our lives. Today, you're going to hear about many situations which officers have gone above and beyond the call of duty. And the reason they do it is simple. It's because they've been obedient to the calling of life in which the Lord has bestowed upon them. With that, would you please join me in a word of prayer? Heavenly Father, we just value this opportunity to gather today in your presence to pay honor to those who have risked their lives in order that we remain a safe and civilized community. We ask for your protection as we continue to serve you and to be used as your servants. We ask for blessings upon our great nation during this time as we remember what the 13th chapter of Romans, which reads, "There is no authority except from God, and those which exist are established by God." Lord, we pray that we as police officers continue to exemplify your love and your affection to all. And it's in your name we pray. Amen. So before we pay honor to those in the room who truly deserve it, would you please join me in remembrance to those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice back on September 11, 2001, and all the years in the past as well, as we welcome the Los Angeles Police Department's Emerald Society, pipes and drums.
put on a uniform every day just for to basically help people, the good people. You know, people talk about different colors, races that are here. For me as a police officer, and for a lot of people, police officers that I know, it's we just see good and bad. And we want to help the good, and we're looking for the bad so we can put them in jail so we can help the good people.
Oh, I would sum up being an LAPD officer as a group of people who have pride in what they do. They have a huge sense of protection for the community and wanting to protect the community. No one ever goes out wanting to hurt anyone when they start their day. Everyone just hopes to come home safe and have everyone that they've had contact with have a positive contact.
I became a LAPD officer because it's the best. There's not a better department in this nation and in the world.
Specifically, I wanted to be an LAPD officer was because growing up watching TV, shows like Adam 12, Police Story, you know, all those popular things that you see, I was impressed that LAPD was the best and that's where I wanted to be.
What I really get out of being an officer, an LAPD officer, and helping the community is knowing that I'm the one that shows up when they call and they need help and seeing their faces when we actually show up and we do help them. That's what really matters.
Yeah, going back to one of the questions I was asked before, it's like, why do I put on the uniform every day? Put it on so I can be with the people that I work with, so that I can be there for them. So that's what inspires me.
I think the donut joke came from, like anything, there's a basis in truth, because we like donuts. Bottom line is, we like donuts.
The donut joke, I don't know where that comes from. I don't see that many people eat them, but I'll handle some Oreos if you got those.
Oh, wow, a donut joke. I would say that is, I don't think I have enough time on the job to really describe that joke.
The donut joke, well, I don't believe it's a joke, and I'm not really much of a donut guy anyway.
Good afternoon. So this is a great event. I've been told just in the last couple of minutes that this is the largest attendance we've ever had for the Medal of Valor event. So thank you to all the sponsors, all the folks that aren't department members for being here, and thanks for all the department members for being here. This is a very important piece of what we do, because at this event, we talk about what we are. We talk about why we're here. This event is all about why Los Angeles police officers become cops. I've been with this organization either as a son of a Los Angeles police officer or as a police officer my entire life. I know a lot about the ethos, the ethic, the core of the LAPD. I know what it takes to be a cop. I know what it takes to become a respected officer of the Los Angeles Police Department. And the things that we value as an organization are somewhat different than maybe some other places, maybe some other police departments across the nation and across the world. And what this organization values is excellence. What this organization values is valor, is heroic action, is the ability to do a really difficult job well. If you're that kind of cop, then you have the most status in this organization. People strive for that. It's an honor to be the chief in an organization like this. Every day, I see heroic action. Every day, I see officers going above and beyond, doing things socially or in the law enforcement realm that are truly far beyond what anybody would expect of a police officer. And that's why today is so special, because this defines what the organization believes is excellence. This is the way that we tell our story. This is the way we tell our story to each other about what it means to be an LAPD cop. Now, I think everybody that wears this uniform, except for probably me, is a hero. I think that just getting in and out of that car every day is a heroic action. But today we talk about something even more. Today we talk about people, men and women, who are able, because of their inner strength, to do things that most people can't. We talk about people that are able to live up to what we all hope that we could do. But it is so rare and so unusual to be put in the circumstances that they face that only they get the opportunity to display the medal that makes a true hero. Now, I love the Los Angeles Police Department, and I think this is what I love most about it, is the people that make it up, the things that they do, and the stories that you will see. Our format's a little different this year, and in an effort to tell the stories as well as we can tell them, and I hope that you appreciate that. But in every one of these stories, in every one of these incidents, whether it's the Preservation of Life Medal, the Purple Heart, or the Medal of Valor itself, we're going to tell you the story of somebody that went above and beyond. Somebody that put their safety in jeopardy for another. Many times, people they don't even know. There can be no finer definition of human being. There can be no finer definition of hero. And there can be no better example of a Los Angeles police officer. So thank you all for being here. It's very important that we not only tell these stories, but we repeat them, that we use them as the examples that they are, and that we celebrate them. Because through that celebration, we encourage this history to continue. We encourage a police department that has been heroic for decades to continue in that vein, in a time when it's not always recognized and when it can be very, very difficult. So thank you for being part of this. I'll turn it back over to Josh. God bless you. God bless the Los Angeles Police Department.
This ballroom is filled with LAPD officers, men and women who, as the chief said, who have selflessly put themselves in harm's way day in and day out to ensure the safety of others. They are faced with life and death situations where they have to rely on their training and their courage and their intuition to make split-second decisions under varied and often dangerous circumstances. This year, the LAPD has adopted a new honor, the Preservation of Life Medal. We have a video that will show you a little bit about that.
The Preservation of Life Medal may be awarded to an officer who has distinguished himself or herself by employing exceptional tactics and exercising sound judgment beyond the normal demands of duty to preserve the life of another during a volatile or dangerous encounter, while protecting the safety and security of the public and his or her fellow officers.
On February 20th, 2015, two North Hollywood Division officers responded to a call of a fleeing motorist from a hit-and-run collision. The officers located the suspect and followed him into an alley where he was standing holding an axe. They were able to de-escalate the situation without harming the suspect. For distinguishing themselves by employing exceptional tactics and exercising sound judgment beyond the normal demands of duty, to preserve the life of another during a volatile or dangerous encounter while protecting the safety and security of the public and their fellow officers. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Eric Andrew Avendano. And to Reserve Officer Stephen Lee. On May 24, 2015, eight Mission Division officers responded to a domestic disturbance call involving a suspect armed with a handgun and a knife. As officers arrived, the suspect fled, driving in excess of 70 miles per hour while firing rounds at the pursuing police vehicles. The pursuit ended when the suspect, lost control of his car and crashed. The suspect exited the car and threatened the officers with a large knife. The officers gave commands for him to drop the weapon. Believing he was about to gain entry into a nearby home, the officers deployed a taser, causing the suspect to fall to the ground. After several commands, the suspect complied and threw the knife away from him. These officers used exceptional tactics to take the suspect into custody without the use of deadly force. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Robert Beatty. Sergeant Stephen Connor. Officer Pedro De La Cruz. Officer Abraham Garcia. Officer Adam Green. Sergeant Andrew Kukla. Officer David Lemus. And Officer Raul Martinez. On August 7, 2015, three Van Nuys Division officers responded to a radio call of a suspect with a deadly weapon. When they arrived at the scene, they found the suspect walking down the street, wielding a large piece of glass and making slashing motions. One officer distracted the suspect while another deployed pepper spray, allowing them to take the suspect into custody without incident. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Cameron Gobble. And Officer Nurses Shakarumian. On September 9, 2015, two Pacific Division officers responded to a report of vandalism in progress. The situation quickly escalated with the suspect holding a knife over an officer who had fallen to the ground. Using quick judgment, a second officer knocked the suspect to the ground, in the process saving his partner. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Alfredo Lamas. On October 13, 2015, several Mission Division officers responded to a call of a man with a gun. When the officers arrived, the suspect urged the officers to shoot him and placed the barrel of the gun in his mouth. Recognizing that the suspect was suicidal, the officers de-escalated the situation and took him into custody without incident. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Joseph Carter. Senior Lead Officer Charles Chacon. Officer Garo Garabedian. Officer John Pastora. Officer Pierre Perez. Officer Francisco Rubio. And Officer Sarah Slavitt. On October 31st, 2015, two Metro Division officers were working crime suppression in Rampart Division when they saw a known gang member loitering and looking suspicious. The officers, both with extensive gang experience, believed he was either carrying a weapon or other contraband. A foot pursuit followed. The suspect pulled out a sawed-off rifle and shot at the officers. The officers worked together to successfully disarm the suspect and take him into custody. The Preservation of Life Medal is presented to Officer Brian Cooney. And Officer Brian Schilling. On March 8, 2016, two Southwest Division officers observed a man walking in the middle of the street with a rifle in his hand while aiming it at passing vehicles. The officers ordered the suspect to drop the rifle. After numerous orders, the suspect finally did. The officers took him into custody. After closer inspection of the firearm, officers learned it was an exact replica of an AR-15 assault rifle. The Preservation of Life Medal is awarded to Officer Danielle Lopez. And Officer Brian Wagner. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Los Angeles Police Department's 2016 Preservation of Life Award recipients. Thank you. following officers could not have foreseen the circumstances they would encounter that would bring them here today. Each gave an extraordinary sacrifice to protect and serve.
The Los Angeles Police Department Purple Heart may be awarded to officers who sustain a traumatic physical injury as a result of a suspect's action during an on-duty tactical situation, or to officers who die in the line of duty as a direct result of a suspect's actions.
On April 27th, 1962, Southwest Division officers Stan Kenzik and Frank Tomlinson were on patrol when they came across two suspects with stolen goods. The officers confronted the suspects for questioning, but the situation quickly escalated when a group of between 20 to 30 men surrounded the officers and attacked them. During the chaos, both officers were brutally beaten and shot several times. Thanks to a good Samaritan who witnessed the incident and called for help, the officers were rescued. As a result of his beatings, Officer Kenzik fell into a coma and was hospitalized for several months. He eventually returned to duty and retired as a captain. Officer Tomlinson underwent several surgeries to correct the damage caused from gunshot wounds. He too, though, returned to full duty and retired as a Detective 3. For sustaining traumatic physical injury during an on-duty tactical situation, the Purple Heart is awarded to retired Captain Stan Kenzik. And retired Detective Frank Tomlinson. On August 25th, 1970, Rampart Division Sergeant William Schmidt was flagged down and advised of a nearby fight. When Schmidt arrived at the scene, he saw a suspect quickly walking away. He ordered the suspect to stop. The suspect began to flee, turned, and fired several shots at Schmidt, striking him in the chest and his right bicep, in the process severing an artery. Despite being critically injured, Schmidt returned fire, wounded the suspect, which led to his quick arrest by responding units. Schmidt spent more than a year recovering from his injuries before returning to duty, was forced to medically retire due to nerve damage to his right arm and hand caused by the gunshot. In 1971, Sergeant Schmidt received the Medal of Valor for his actions during this incident. Today, the Purple Heart is awarded to retired Sergeant William Schmidt. Accepting on his behalf is his son, Kenneth Schmidt. On May 29, 1974, Officer Richard Kalmbaugh and three others boarded a Bell Jet Ranger to conduct live fire exercises. At some point during the flight, the aircraft violently collided into a hillside and burst into flames with all four occupants trapped inside. Kalmbaugh, who was the most seriously injured, sustained second and third degree burns over 40 to 50% of his body, as well as damage to both his eyes. He remained in intensive care for some time, requiring numerous surgeries and skin grafts. The Purple Heart is awarded to retired detective Richard Kalmbaugh. On April 2nd, 1977, Southwest Division Officer Roy Mears and his partner were on patrol when they passed a Grand Theft Auto suspect driving erratically on the street. Mears and his partner initiated a pursuit. The suspect jumped out of his moving vehicle and fled on foot. Mears, without hesitation, jumped out of his squad car in pursuit. A fence Mears jumped during the pursuit broke, causing injury to his right knee. He continued and caught up with the suspect when a struggle ensued. During the struggle, the suspect grabbed and bent Mears' thumb, causing the tendon to snap. Mears battled through the injuries and eventually detained the suspect. Officer Mears endured several surgeries for his thumb and his knee, and he was forced to medically retire in 1978. The Purple Heart is awarded to retired Officer Roy Mears. On June 27, 1979, Newton Division Officer John Puiz and his partner responded to a home where a mentally ill man tried to choke his mother. Unaware the suspect was armed, Puiz kicked in the door where the suspect was hiding. The suspect fired a rifle, and Puiz was hit with a bullet to his right shoulder, the force of which turned him around, slammed him against the wall, and caused him to drop his service revolver. The suspect continued shooting, hitting Puiz in the right side of his neck with another bullet traveling through his leg to the spine. To avoid his fellow officers being shot, Puiz did not call for assistance and managed to drag himself out of the house to safety. Officer Puiz received the Medal of Valor for his actions in 1980. Today, the Purple Heart is awarded to retired Officer John Puiz. On March 10, 1980, Detective Curtis Hagley, assigned to Detective Support and Vice Division, he and other officers were in pursuit of two armed robbery suspects. A gun battle ensued, and Hagley was severely wounded. He succumbed to his injuries shortly after being taken to a local hospital. For giving his life in the line of duty, the Purple Heart is posthumously awarded to Detective Curtis Hagley, accepting on behalf of his son, Brett Hagley, and daughter, Paige Elway. On April 8, 1982, 77th Street Division Officer Peter Hunter and his partner were on patrol when officers observed a man walking down the street with a shotgun. The suspect ignored commands from officers to drop the weapon and ran toward a building and then out of sight. One of the officers peered around the corner and was struck in the head by pellets from the subject's shotgun. Officer Hunter returned fire, wounding the suspect in the leg. Seeing his fellow officer hit and lying in the line of fire, Hunter tried to drag him to safety. As he was assisting the officer, the suspect fired another round, striking Hunter in the head and eye. He underwent surgery to remove shotgun pellets from one eye and was forced to take a medical retirement nearly a year later. The Purple Heart is awarded to retired officer Peter Hunter. On May 15, 1988, Northeast Division Officer Anthony Lopez and his partner responded to a call in Hollywood of an elderly woman fighting with her mentally ill son. When officers arrived, they found the son had locked himself in the apartment. As Lopez's partner unlocked the door, the suspect yanked it open and began attacking the officers with a large kitchen knife. Lopez fired his weapon at the suspect, striking him, causing him to fall to the ground. As Lopez moved to handcuff the suspect, he realized that he had a wound and was bleeding from his right thigh. The Purple Heart is awarded to Officer Anthony Lopez. On April 30th, 1993, LAPD officer Henry Hilton was in pursuit of an armed robbery suspect when the gunman grabbed a 12-year-old girl as a hostage and pointed a pistol at her head and attempted to escape in a car. West Traffic Division officer Stephen Kehoe arrived on the scene to offer backup when a gun battle erupted. As the suspect attempted to get away in a car with the young hostage, Kehoe left the cover of his car to draw attention away from the hostage and get a better shot. The suspect fired his weapon, hitting Kehoe in the right thigh and left shoulder, and drove off with the young hostage. Despite his wounds, Kehoe jumped on his motorcycle and began a pursuit that ended with the suspect's car crashing. Backup units arrived and took him into custody, and the girl was released unharmed. Officers Henry and Kehoe both received the Medal of Valor for their heroic actions. The Purple Heart is today awarded to retired officer Stephen Kehoe. On July 26, 1995, SIS detectives Larry Winston and Phil Wixon were conducting surveillance on two men suspected of committing 24 armed robberies. The officers were moving in to make an arrest when suddenly one of the suspects stood up through the sunroof of a vehicle and began shooting. Wixon was struck by one of the rounds, which penetrated his ballistic vest and entered his abdomen. Struggling to breathe, Wixon managed to fire several rounds back at the suspects. As the gun battle continued, Winston was hit in the groin by a bullet from another detective. Despite his injury, Winston fired several more rounds at the suspects in an effort to draw their attention away from his wounded partner. Both detectives previously received the Medal of Valor for their actions. The Purple Heart is awarded to Detective Lawrence Winston. Accepting for him is retired Detective Richard Calbaugh. And it is awarded to Detective Philip Wixon. Accepting for Detective Wixon today is his son-in-law, LAPD Officer Sven Stephenson. On January 15, 2015, Devonshire Division Officer Jay Espiritu and his partner responded to a complaint of narcotics activity when they observed a possible narcotics transaction between two people. When Espiritu identified himself as a police officer to the driver of the car, he immediately accelerated. Officer Espiritu tried to grab at the chest of the driver while holding onto the steering wheel of the suspect's vehicle, precariously balancing his body inside the vehicle with the door partially open. Seeing no other alternative and realizing the vehicle was traveling in excess of 40 miles per hour, Espiritu pulled the wheel down and to the left, forcing the car to strike a curb and travel up onto the sidewalk. The driver's door hit a large tree, causing the door to violently slam onto the hip and legs of Officer Espiritu. He was crushed between the door and the doorpost, and it caused instant unconsciousness. He suffered extreme injuries and was in the hospital for more than a month and spent 9 months before recovering and returning to duty. The Purple Heart is awarded to Officer Jay Espiritu. On July 30th, 2011, Topanga Division Officers Mark De La Torre and Francisco Rubio were working the aftermath of a gang fight when Rubio saw a speeding car heading toward him and his partner. He immediately grabbed De La Torre and screamed to alert other officers of the oncoming danger. The speeding vehicle struck Rubio's squad car, sending it into a 180-degree spin and hitting Officer De La Torre. Rubio was also struck and sent more than 15 feet into the air, causing him to land on the back of his skull nearly 50 feet away. Officer De La Torre suffered a multitude of bone injuries and muscle damage. Officer Rubio sustained a severe brain injury in addition to bone injuries. The Purple Heart is awarded to Officer Mark De La Torre. And Officer Francisco Rubio. For performing an act displaying extreme courage while consciously facing imminent peril, the Medal of Honor, the Medal of Valor, is awarded to Officer Francisco Rubio. This would be the third medal Officer Rubio is being honored with today. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Los Angeles Police Department's 2016 Purple Heart recipients. That perfect valor is doing without witnesses what you would do if the whole world were watching. The following officers we recognize today with the Medal of Valor found courage not in search of recognition, they did it instinctively. We are very grateful that they were there on duty and off duty, all rising above and beyond the call of duty.
The Medal of Valor is the department's highest award and may be awarded to employees who distinguish themselves by conspicuous bravery or heroism above and beyond the normal demands of police service. To be awarded the Medal of Valor, an employee must have performed an act displaying extreme courage while consciously facing imminent peril.
On July 31st, 2015, Hollenbeck Division officers Junior McMeekin and Daniel Navarro responded to a traffic collision of two mangled cars in the roadway, one of which was on fire. Without hesitation, the officers ran toward the cars to make sure all occupants were safe and away from the wreckage. They noticed that one of the drivers was slumped over his seat and unconscious. Even though the vehicle was completely engulfed in flames, the officers broke the driver's side window and forced the door open. They pulled the driver to safety and saved his life. For distinguishing themselves by conspicuous bravery or heroism above and beyond the normal demands of police service, the Medal of Valor is awarded to Officer Junior McMeekin. And Officer Daniel Navarro. On February 27, 2016, Officer Victor Ortiz was off duty and driving home with his family when he witnessed a horrific fiery crash. A speeding vehicle had hit a UPS truck, causing the driver to lose control, strike the center median, become airborne, and land on the opposite side of the freeway, hitting a sedan there and catching fire. After the UPS truck came to rest, an oncoming SUV immediately collided with it, and the SUV quickly became engulfed in flames. Although he was initially pinned down in the front of his car, the SUV's driver was able to work his way to the vehicle's cargo area. He yelled for help and tried to kick out the rear windows. As he struggled to free himself, he says he felt the vehicle heat up and his arms start to burn. He saw people standing 50 feet away, but no one was willing to approach the burning wreck. Officer Ortiz had already gotten out of his car and was checking on people at the scene. He heard the SUV driver's cries for help, made eye contact with him, and despite the flames and intense heat, ran toward the vehicle. Officer Ortiz located the release hatch for the back of the vehicle, opened it, grabbed the trapped driver by his arms, and pulled him 30 feet away to safety. Someone yelled that the UPS truck was about to blow up. Ortiz grabbed the driver a second time and pulled him further away just as the UPS truck exploded, sending flames and debris into the air. He then stayed with the rescued driver until paramedics arrived. The Medal of Valor is awarded to Officer Vincent Ortiz. On March 24, 2014, Hollywood Division Officer Sheila Sparkman and Josue Pena responded to a radio call of a domestic disturbance. When the officers arrived, the situation quickly spun out of control with the suspect shooting a volley of rounds at the officers. One of the suspect's bullets shattered a large mirror within inches of Officer Sparkman's head, causing bullet fragments, mirrored glass, and wood from the door frame to strike her in the face and in the eyes. As blood poured down her face, she returned fire. Seeing that his partner was injured, Officer Pena pulled Sparkman from the bathroom and guided her to safety. She was transported to a local medical center for treatment of her wounds. The Medal of Honor is presented to Officer Josue Pena. Thank you, Medal of Honor. Medal of Valor. And to retired Officer Sheila Sparkman. For sustaining traumatic physical injury during an on-duty tactical situation, the Purple Heart is also awarded to retired Officer Sheila Sparkman. On August 28, 2014, 77th Street Division officers Gabriel Hogeen and Michael Munjakovich were on patrol when they observed a vehicle driving recklessly. They activated their sirens and began a pursuit. The vehicle reached speeds in excess of 80 miles per hour and was weaving in and out of traffic when it suddenly stopped. The front passenger, leaped out of the car and opened fire on both officers with an assault rifle. In fear for his life and for that of his partner, Officer Munjakovich fired 5 rounds through the windshield of their police vehicle. The passenger then closed his door and the vehicle took off again. The officers gave chase and made a second call to say they were now under fire. As other officers joined the pursuit, the driver of the vehicle lost control and collided into a tree. The driver managed to escape the wreckage and flee on foot. The passenger exited the car firing the assault rifle. The armed suspect began to run while turning back to continue firing at the officers. SWAT and Metro K-9 personnel arrived on scene to help search for the two suspects. Officer Cliff Chu was working with his K-9 Ringo, who alerted the officers to the location of one of the suspects. Officers Chu, Kanan, Bodell, Timothy McCarthy, and Isaac Moreno ordered the suspect to surrender. When he did not comply, a stun grenade was deployed. The suspect relented and was taken into custody. Search teams located the second suspect. 2 armed vehicles were sent in to extract him. As the MedCat, operated by Officer Bodell and Officer Howard Ang, moved forward, the suspect fired his rifle and raised his rifle and fired at the officers. Officers Mario Rios, John Ferraro, Bodell, Nelson Fong, James Gastello, Howard Ang, McCarthy, Chu, and Robert Gallegos all fired their weapons. The suspect fired again, striking Fong. He returned fire, fell backwards onto the ground, and grabbed his knee. Ferraro then pulled him to safety. Gastello and other officers fired again, striking the suspect. An arrest team then approached him and took him into custody without further incident. Officers provided immediate medical attention to Fong until he could be taken to a hospital where the medical team was able to save his critically injured leg. The Medal of Valor is awarded to Officer Kanan Bodell. Officer Cliff Chu. Officer John Ferraro. Officer Robert Gallegos. Officer James Gastello. Sergeant Gabriel Hogeen. Officer Isaac Moreno. Officer Michael Munjakovich. Officer Howard Ang. Officer Mario Rios. And Officer Nelson Fong. And for sustaining traumatic physical injury during an on-duty tactical situation, the Purple Heart is also awarded to Officer Nelson Fong. On a special note, it was brought to our attention that Officer Fong only yesterday returned to full duty with the SWAT team and just this morning responded to his first SWAT incident since being critically wounded. Welcome back. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Los Angeles Police Department's 2016 Medal of Valor recipients. Officers we have recognized here today took an oath to protect and serve the city of Los Angeles. Their stories of going above and beyond the call of duty and, for one, dying in the line of duty have earned them a place among the heroes and legends of the LAPD. Thank you all for coming. Thank you for coming to honor them and for supporting the Los Angeles Police Department. Thanks very much.